people is like being servant unto him, like being a slave. If you have a master, if we only have one master, then how is it that we have other masters and we're in servitude too? And that's like being unto God. Like, I'm confused on that as well. As well as the other things.
You're going to have to give us a precept to explain what you're talking about. Because I've already told you that slavery under the Israelites were not as this modern day slavery. Slaves had rights.
I understand what you're saying, but there is scripture that says that.
Give me the scripture.
Have no other God besides our God, no master. Man cannot serve two masters. But then the scripture turns around and says that, you know, your masters are put man as being your master. So, yeah, I question that as well.
Okay, so give me the scripture.
I don't remember the scripture by heart.
I don't know. There's a lot of scriptures in the Bible about slavery. I don't know which one you're specifically, but this is what I mean when I tell you to cite a source and you can't cite it.
Yeah, because that means you're regurgitating information that you don't even understand.
Yeah, she just heard someone say something, and it sounds relevant until someone comes along that knows the scripture, and then break it down.
No, I read it myself. I just don't remember the book by heart where I read it. I'm not regurgitating something I heard somebody else say. I read this myself.
Then you should be able to tell us where to go. You bringing it up.
Well, I didn't know that this was going to be a Bible study. I don't have my Bible in front of me.
It's not a Bible study. You brought it up about how you really don't believe in all of the Bible and the Bible's been tampered with. And I told you to cite me the sources where it's been tampered with. And we can help you out with that.
Right. Well, this is some of the things I question.
That's not a tamper.
When I say the book has been tampered with, there's a lot of books that didn't get put into the Bible. There was a lot of books removed from the Bible. They decided what went in the Bible and what wasn't going to go in.
Who's they?
The scribes or the popes.
The scribes didn't do that.
Either the pope, then it must have been the pope, deciding that.
So you can't even explain what you're talking about here, man.
What I'm talking about. The Bible is, that book is not whole. Some things have been added and some things have been taken away.
Bible I have is whole. So you're just regurgitating information, man.
I'm not regurgitating anything. These are
okay. Things. Which books are missing from the Bible?
No, all of the books, but there are books that are missing from it.
Which books are missing from the Bible?
it's the book of Enoch.
What? That don't belong in the Bible. That's garbage. Okay. You're reading too much folklore.
So there's several books that did not make it into the Bible.
Like what?
What books was going to make it in? I have my Sephira somewhere around here, but I packed it up because I'm in the middle of moving. But literally, things have been added and things have been taken away. I do believe in the Most High God. But a book that other people have had, who the translations have changed from time to time, yeah, I'm going to question it. I'm not going to just be blind. I'm going to question those things. I need a little bit more
reading. You know, I'm going to tell you this, sis.
But
if you don't repent, the Most High is going to jack you up because you're coming with demons, man. You're obviously dealing with some spirits.
Not dealing with spirits. I'm dealing.
Yeah, you don't want to face it, but you're dealing with spirits. You're following. So what exactly are you following then?
I'm not. First of all, what I follow is the Most High. So I
am. You don't follow the Most High. That's blasphemy.
Yeah. No.
You cannot follow the Most High and you bringing up books about Egyptology because he forbids that.
Excuse me, but this is a world of learning. So you read.
No, you are not following the Most High, man. May the Most High curse you for bringing that out of your mouth.
Okay.
Or everything I love. You're not following the Most High, man. You can't cite these other books and say you're following the Most High because he forbids that. You're going against the very book that. So, and if you're following the Most High, what is the criteria upon which you're following him? I asked you that earlier.
It's always Eve. It's always Eve.
What do you mean, it's always Eve?
No, don't divert. What is the criteria upon which you're basing you following the Most High?
Because I'm following the Most High.
Well, how? How do you
what
know
do you you're mean? Doing
that? How do you know you're doing? What are you doing on a day-to-day that you know that you're doing the will of the Most High?
Do any of us know that we're doing the word of the
There has to be some sort of criteria. My point exactly.
It's called the Torah. There's laws. It's not a religion. It's a way of life. The way life was meant to be. There's only one truth. Remember that. Yes, the truth has been distorted. We're not denying that.
Hey, Panay, did you ever find that?
Yes, Jewish Antiquities, Book 1, Chapter 8, Paragraph 2.
So you could destroy that damn book that she's reading, that comic book.
Whereas the Egyptians were formerly addicted to different customs.
Okay, so stop. So there was a division amongst those Egyptian people that she's following that nonsense, right? They was divided. They didn't know what to follow. Go ahead and read.
And despised one another's sacred and accustomed rites.
Okay. So the Egyptians was divided. They was going each other customs rites. This is why they have over 200 gods, first of all. Go ahead.
And were very angry one with another on that account.
So the Egyptians was very angry with each other. Go ahead.
Abram conferred with each of them.
Now, this is Abraham. Abraham went into Egypt, and he started conferring with these Egyptians because they was arguing with each other. What are we reading? The book of Josephus. Go ahead, read on.
And confuting the reasonings they made use of, mm-hmm. every one for their own practices, demonstrated that such reasonings were vain and void of truth.
So they was doing things in vain, the Egyptians. This was before Abraham went there. See, a lot of you don't even know Abraham went into Egypt and taught them. God.
Whereupon he was admired by them in those conferences as a very wise man.
So Abraham was considered to be a wise man amongst the Egyptians. You didn't find that in your book, huh? God.
And one of great wisdom, when he discoursed on any subject he undertook.
Any subject that he undertook. So here's the Israelite that they told you they didn't know anything over there teaching the Egyptians. Go ahead.
And this not only in understanding it, but in persuading other men also to assent to him.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
He communicated to them arithmetic.
So Abraham taught the Egyptians arithmetic. They said, oh, everything you learn out of Egypt. It's a lie. Study history. You'll find out it's a lie. Go ahead.
And delivered to them the science of astronomy.
He taught them astronomy also.
For before Abram came into Egypt, they were unacquainted with those parts of learning.
Before Abraham came into Egypt, they wasn't acquainted with the mathematics and the astronomy. How about that? Well, how do you like that? They say all of these books existed before the Bible. Things that make you go, huh? And also, that's from the writings of Josephus.
Which is a known historical source.
How you deal with that, Sharon?
I'm listening.
No, he's finished. He's done, dear.
Okay.
So what is your response to that? Because you say, no, these things existed before the Bible.
And I heard what he said, and I will continue to study. That's what I'm here for.
It doesn't, but listen, this is what I want to say to you, sis. You cannot follow the word of the Most High and then go over there and pull that Egypt. So I'll ask you like I asked all Egyptologists, right? Give me one prophecy in those Egyptian books that has come to pass and is still coming to pass, like the Basura and the Torah and the Tanakh. Give me one prophecy, because I could go and show you prophecy as a prophecy, like things are unfolding still today.
I'll wait.
Okay right now. And I think this is why you can't heal properly, because you're dealing with demons. And you don't want to accept that, but you're dealing with demons. These books, now you got a lot of people on this call. Well, let me show you something real quick. You got a lot of people on this call saying the same thing, but let me show you something about this stuff. Do you know Set and Osiris and all those people was pretty much homosexuals?
Yeah.
Well, let me show you something.
Oh, freaked out.
This is an Egyptian mirror right here. You see this? This is an Egyptian mirror. These are two homosexual lovers. You see what these men are doing? They're wrestling, but they used to wrestle naked. The Greeks picked this up. The Greeks called it gymnasians. Mm. When you go and look at the etymology of the word gymnasian, it means naked wounds. That's what the word gym comes from.
Come.
You see what these men are doing? I'll show you some more. These are from your so-called powers, gods. Yeah. Look at this. This one's more, I hope they don't flag the video for this, because this one's even more provocative. Look at that. There's your Egyptian gods. Look at that. These are Egyptian mirrors right here. Why didn't they teach you about this stuff? Now, our book forbids this. Look at that.
Child sacrifice.
That's a man going up another man's backside.
That's very, very freaky.
And you follow this.
Yeah, those
you never hear him debate all over. Look at this, man. These are two guys right here. These are their mirrors. So why don't you know about this stuff, but you know about the other stuff? It's just as easy to find.
See, that's the beginning of the destruction of any society. You cannot sustain a society with them kind of acts and those type of relationships. Yeah, that destroys a nuclear family.
It's as old as their mirrors, man.
And a lot of our people want to have Egypt pride. If they forget about King Narma, who conquered the southern part of Egypt, they think that this is just like, this is our African pride. They don't know that they were like the major world powers, the elite, the oppressors. Who do we think built those pyramids? The slaves, the Hebrews of the Torah. And that's what's so sad about our people. And sister, I'm not coming at you or anything, but if you think about it, they live such a luxurious lifestyle. Look at the pyramids right now that's sitting up there right now in ruins. Just like Nero's sunken city in ruins. Egypt wasn't great. Child sacrifice.